In this process simulator solution, we're going to show you how to calculate different entity times. So your model will automatically calculate how long it took for an entity to go through the whole model, but maybe you want to know how long it took for it to process at one location, or how long it took to capture resource and process, or whatever the case may be. So here in this example model, we have a car that goes through our wash, wax, and vacuum locations, and we're going to calculate some different times for each activity. So let's start with our wash activity. For the wash activity, we're going to calculate the time it takes for it to enter the activity and exit out. Enter the activity, we're going to calculate the time it takes from when the car arrives, routes out of the wash. So the way we do that, we'll right click into the properties of the car arrival and click into the logic. So we set an attribute a start time equal to the clock, which is basically a timestamp that is held within that attribute value. Now if we go to the properties of our routing out of the wash and click into the logic, we have our VWash time equal to the clock minus our start time. So that will give us the amount of time from when the car arrived to when it routed out. Now the time we're going to calculate here in the wax activity, we're just going to calculate the total time it took to process the car. So let's right click into this activity, and you'll notice we don't have a general time or a resource captured. With the drop-down general resource option, since we'll do that in the logic. So let's click into the logic. First we get the worker, and then we set our start time, and then we have our processing time. Then right after that we have our VWAX time equal to the clock minus the start time, so that will give us whatever value was returned here in our wait time. And then now we'll go on to our vacuum activity. In this activity, we're going to calculate the time it took to capture the resource and process. So the only difference between this one and the wax is we put our start time before we capture the resource. So let's look at the properties of the vacuum to see how that is set up and click into the logic. So like I said, our start time is set before the resources captured, and so if the resource isn't available immediately, there will be time in addition to the processing time that is captured. So we have our timestamp, we capture the worker, we have our processing time, we free the worker, and then our variable is set equal to the clock minus the start time. So using this method to capture entity times can be used anywhere in your model So you can use this method to calculate any time it takes for an entity to go from point A to point B. You just have to know what sequence the model runs things and put your start time and end time in the correct locations. So let's run the simulation and we'll take a look at our simulation results. In order to capture those variable values, you have a few different options. You can go to your tables and select the variable summary, and this table will give you the minimum value, the maximum value, the average time for change, the current value, and the average value of those variables. If you want a more detailed summary of those variables, you can go to your time plot and select the different variables you want displayed in the chart. And right now these are set as a periodic average. You can select none, and then you'll get all the different values that those variables had. And you can even export this to an Excel sheet so you can see, so you can have all those variables in a spreadsheet to calculate whatever statistics you want. All you have to do is go to export chart data and export the data for the selected chart to Excel. And that's how you calculate different entity times. And that concludes this solution. Have a great day and happy modeling.